Hey friends, GatorMom here. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a great day. Today I'm doing a quick little video going through this MZ Wallace Crosby Convertible Wristlet. All right, so I've had this Crosby Convertible Wristlet in a number of my packing videos lately, as well as kind of sharing it a little bit over on Instagram. And so many of you wanted me to do a more detailed walkthrough and kind of show the ins and outs of this crossbody and the pockets and all of that fun stuff. So I thought today I would do a quick little overview of this one, as well as my small Crosby wallet that I have here, which is another really popular one that you guys are wanting to see up close and in more detail. So let's go ahead and get into this one first. So I have it packed up like fully. This is if I was literally just going out of the house with just this, or sometimes I'll keep it packed like this if I'm throwing it into a larger bag and I have things in the bag like just for the kids, and I'll keep all of my things in this particular wristlet. But I have attached over here on the side my Touchland hand sanitizer, just because it's really easy to loop it inside this little clip right here. And then of course over here on the side I have my Oventure silicone key ring attached with my keys. These are just two really easy items that I can just throw on the side of the wristlet here and not have to take up space on the inside. All right, now that I have those items off of the bag, you can really see it in more detail without them flopping around. I did want to just kind of show how I would typically carry it, just because it's really easy to attach them here on the side of the bag. But this crossbody is so awesome. I love it. I love the versatility of it, and I like how small and compact it is, yet it really does hold a lot. It holds way more than you think it would hold. There's a couple different ways, of course, that you can carry it. It comes with this optional crossbody strap. It is not adjustable or anything like that. It is a chain strap, so it kind of gives a little bit of like an elegance to this, I guess you could say. The chain is really nice quality. It's not cheap feeling or anything like that. And then the leather top of the chain here is trimmed in their signature kind of red like line around the side that typical MZ Wallace leather has. You can easily take it off here on the side if you didn't want the strap attached to the bag. And then just carry it as a wallet, which I typically do 9 times out of 10. If I'm throwing it inside a bag or something, and then I'll just put the chain like inside the bag. The other way that you can carry it is by the optional wristlet strap, which is that same leather that I was just showing you on just a simple wristlet. So you could just attach this here on the side and then carry the bag like that as well. Looking here at the front of this wristlet here, it is obviously their quilted material that's so nice, high quality, really, really soft. This color is coastal blue. I believe they have it also in black right now, maybe a plum in the past. There's been a couple of different colors of this, and I'm sure they'll continue to release more. But basically here in the front, you have the classic plated MZ Wallace logo. Then you have one zipper with the leather zipper pull. And then you have two little corners down here that are also leather trimmed here on the side. So I don't have anything in this pocket. Oh, no, I lied. See, I'm not even sure what I have in here. I have my face mask in here. I'll usually just kind of throw it and tuck it in the big part. But if I have time or not being lazy, I will tuck it in this zipper pocket. As you can see with it in there, I couldn't even really tell that it was inside that pocket. It's just a perfect little pocket for something like that. So that's what's inside that front pocket there. Turning the bag around to the back here, I'll show you the sides real quickly. You just have a little button there that has the ring attached to it. Nothing there on the bottom of the bag. And then the back also mirrors those leather kind of corner squares there. There is one magnetic snap closure back here, which is the perfect pocket for my cell phone. I'm actually surprised I didn't pop that in there. But it fits in there perfectly. This is an iPhone 11 Pro, just for size reference. I'm sure even if you have a bigger cell phone, it could just stick up a little bit. And I have one of those loopy cases on there, and it fits in there just fine. So that's what I will usually tuck down in there, or receipts or something like that, depending on if I have my phone in my pocket or something like that. So now moving in to the inside of this bag, it opens up just with one flap that does have a magnetic closure. And right as you open it up, you have one pocket right here. I don't believe again that I have anything in here. Oh, I have a nail file. This is usually like gum, a nail file, hair ties, things like that, all kind of like small compact things. I had some cough drops in here, but it's just a nice little open like zipper pocket. This bag is fully lined in RFID protection for like your cards and whatnot. So I thought that was a really interesting thing to note about this one that I did not know when I first got it. In this big part of the bag here, as you can see, there's so much room here on the inside. You could easily put a cell phone down in there if you wanted to. I just have a couple of things like a pill case. This has like Advil and Excedrin. I also have a chapstick in there. And then there's the hair tie. Told you I had one in here. And then down here at the bottom, I just have a small little portable hand cream, as well as one of my favorite lip glosses from Tarte Cosmetics. So, and as you can see, obviously I had so much more room to put other things down in there, but I just kind of threw a couple of things that I was needing. So on the inside here, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 card slots. And then directly behind the card slots, you have one big open kind of billfold slot, if you will. I just have a couple of receipts, some Old Navy cash there. But this would be a great spot for cash or checks or anything that's long like that that you need to store in here, kind of separate from the inside of the bag there. And then directly behind that, which I think is so unique, you have another little zipper pocket that's trimmed in that same little leather zipper pull. And inside here, I actually just have a deposit I need to make at the bank and a couple of these little arcade cards for my kids. So that's what I had inside that pocket, but obviously you can use it for whatever you'd like. So that is a quick little review of what this convertible wristlet looks like. Now let's get into the small Crosby wallet. All right, so like I mentioned earlier, this is the small Crosby wallet from MZ Wallace, of course, and this particular Crosby wallet does come in a couple of different sizes, if I'm not mistaken. I know there's a long wallet version as well as a mini. I'm not sure if there's others. I just grabbed this one because I really liked the way that it was set up on the inside. This is another great wallet. You guys have seen me use it a ton. It has like the classic leather zipper pull down here. The leather corner squares do wrap all the way around the bottom here of the wallet and then up the back of it here. So that's really nice. I feel like it just kind of adds a little bit more structure and support to the wallet, having them wrap the whole way around like that. So I really like that. Again, it's just really slim and compact and in that great like quilted material that we're used to from MZ Wallace. On the front of the bag here, you do have, of course, the MZ Wallace plaque, and then you have one zipper right across the top. The lining is a bright red lining, which is really fun. I don't have anything inside that pocket, but it's great for little receipts or whatever you need, like a hair tie or something like that, I'll throw in the front of it. It is a small pocket, not much will fit in there, but you could even use this front pocket for change if you wanted to. On the back of it, you don't have anything, no pockets or anything like that. You just have, of course, these leather corners, and they're trimmed also in that red leather there. When you unzip this wallet, it unzips all the way around and opens up completely flat. What sold me on this wallet was the way that it was set up and the way that it was kind of structured, because I do think that it's very different than any other wallet that I've seen out there. My one and only complaint about this wallet, if I had to pick something, is I do really miss the ID picture pocket. Like, even if that was on the outside of the wallet, or maybe right here instead of this little coin like zipper pouch, I think I would really like that. So since it does not have that, I have my ID and insurance cards tucked behind there. And that goes all the way down. It doesn't stick up or anything like these top two do. So up over here, I just have a couple of gift cards. Over on this side, it is exactly the same, only doesn't have this particular zipper. It just has a spot for cards. So I just have 3 credit cards. They do fit in there quite tight. I'm not sure that you could double up there, but you have extra room here behind that I don't have anything in. And then I put my card that I use the most frequently up here because it's really easy to just kind of pull it in and out. There are additional pockets right here on the side as well as over here on this side. So lots of room in here, yet still remaining small and compact. You also have a built-in like billfold back here for cash or receipts or anything like that that you need. So I really just like the way that it's structured. I like how thin it is, and it fits really comfortably in a lot of my bags. All right, so there you have it. There's my quick little review on both of these MZ Wallace wallets that you guys have been asking about. I hope this was helpful and I answered all of your questions. If there is something I didn't answer, feel free to ask below. I'm always happy to help. I will have the link to MZ Wallace below so that you can go ahead and check these out for yourself. Like I said, I do believe there are additional colors and maybe even some more styles that mimic kind of this Crosby one. So definitely head over and check it out. I'll see you guys on my next video. Have a great night.